Hello, everybody. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to Madden 18 on EA Sports. The winding road to the Super Bowl continues here in the divisional round, where two teams look to take another step towards the Super Bowl. It's the Saints going up against the Vikings.
It's one of the new jewels of the NFL, no doubt, as you get a look inside U.S. Bank Stadium here in Minneapolis. Ahead, we'll decide the second entrant to next week's NFC title game, as we've got a great one in store between the New Orleans Saints and the Minnesota Vikings. Who will punch the fourth and final ticket to the conference championship round? We'll know soon enough as we are underway here on a January afternoon. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Minnesota Vikings, here comes the offense. Now, they'll have to face a much improved New Orleans defense. Now, they saw New Orleans in week one, Charles, but this quarterback, Case Keenum, it wasn't him that started that game. That was Sam Bradford, remember?
It was, and here's where it's interesting. Sam Bradford was a monster in that game against New Orleans. Threw for big yardage, pinpoint accuracy. Looked like this offense was really going to elevate under him, but he hurt his knee. Never the same after that. Case Keenum took over, and the offense morphed and changed to fit Case Keenum's style. A little more movement, bootlegs, no quarterback run game, but just moving him out of the pocket to get him some sight lines. Be interesting to see what Case Keenum does against a much better New Orleans defense this time around as they try and win a playoff game at home.
I think defensively, you're okay with that. You're in the first quarter. He's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
Off play action, Keenum. Flushed out right. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. Manti Te'o in there to get him for a loss of three. And it'll be fourth down.
Green 39.
They are going for it. Keenum. And this is incomplete. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the Saints are going to get it back and in great shape. So shall we say a bold decision to go for it. And that bold decision does not pay off.
And when you talk about bold, you're saying all caps?
All caps.
Yeah, without a doubt. Maybe they're telling their defense they have a lot of faith in them. I mean, that's how you have to spin it, is that you tell your defense, you know something? We were able to go for it there because you guys are so good. I'm not worried about things. That's the only explanation I can come up with in this situation.
Well, he better get ready to spin it for that post-game presser because you know he's going to be out.
He's going to have to spin it for his own locker room, frankly.
On second down, Ingram. So he got free of one tackle but couldn't do a whole lot else. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
He dumps it down to Ingram. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Big completion there on third and short, keeps their opening drive alive.
Not only alive, but plenty of possibilities now. First and goal, and you know me, I'm a big advocate. If you're going to throw the ball, throw it early in the down and distance count.
And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. And that one was relatively easy to see. I noticed that from up here.
Yeah, it doesn't take a whole lot, does it? Sometimes you get multiples. What I always love on these offsides is when each side points at the other. Hey, you did it. No, you did it. They deciphered that one correctly.
There's Breeze. The Vikings after him, and they get there for the sack. Everson Griffin in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about eight.
Well, if you're going to throw the ball on first and goal from the two, the worst thing that should result is an incompletion for you offensively. But Brandon, this is a different type of football. Back in my day, first and goal from the two, a lot of big people with big neck rolls, they were on the field trying to ram it into the end zone.
The catch good for 6 yards, but now it's third and goal.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive, he may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game, too.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield, but when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
And Lutz puts this one through. And the Saints are going to take a 3-0 lead. So give them three there. A good drive gets them inside the five, but they couldn't punch it in.
And credit this defense, too. That was the old bend but don't break approach. But it kept the offense out of the end zone.
Oh, he's got some breathing room. Accelerating, and off he goes. Touchdown, Vikings.
That was a special return, and it happened because he's a special returner. He has to have that approval from his special teams coach's head coach to bring it out of the end zone.
But let's be honest, a lot of times where they bring it out of the end zone like he did there, they don't have approval. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting a feel, right?
You're exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules. And if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
Kai Forbath on for the extra point. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. On the return, it's Ted Ginn Jr. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
Now Breeze on the bootleg. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third. The play fake to Ingram. Now it's Breeze. Now Breeze lost the football. And he will not get all the way home, but he will take this back down to about the 2-yard line.
Hey, whatever happened to the days of just getting a fumble recovery? Everyone's into taking it the other way and trying to create points themselves, aren't they?
Well, they are. And now a terrific opportunity inside the five. Following the fumble recovery, Keenum. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, Brandon, we see why it's a team game there, because there's a sigh of relief that they just released defensively. If he's able to get that one away, that's likely a touchdown. But instead, that pressure from the front got to him and forced the incompletion.
You're right. He had him open just a split second too late on the release. Now Keenum throwing on second. Flush to his right. And he can't corral it. Maybe a big missed opportunity there defensively in the end zone. And now third down.
All right, Captain. It's batting down the hatches time defensively. Dodge two pass attempts to the end zone. Now what do you think they're going to try and dial up on third and goal?
Well, knowing them and knowing what we just seen, I think they're throwing it again, don't you?
I think you have to. I think in
this. And he's going to go down. This will count as a sack, a very short sack. Taken down at the 2. Phillip Wheeler in there.
there for the sack on what will be the final play of this first quarter. One quarter gone in this NFC Divisional. Back now with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gaudin. Second quarter begins with the Vikings holding the football. They are, however, facing a fourth down situation. And Forbath will put this one through. And they push the lead up to a touchdown now at 10-3. So they had great field position, but a three-play drive that actually goes backwards, and then they kick the field goal.
And I think the key sequence in there, the key phrase you just gave us, a three-play drive, had the momentum, great field position, unable to move the football.
And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal and they were able to trot back out on the field and start this drive? A little more pep in their step because it didn't cost their team a touchdown, but they know they've got to do it a lot better than they did on the last possession.
The coach will just be relieved, though, if they recoup with a score here, right?
I think coach will be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield and punch in the end zone without turning it over.
Rush coming in. He's taken down. Ben Gideon in there to drop him, and that will go into the books as the first sack of his young NFL career.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely been on constant duress this entire.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And the Vikings pick up the football. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
Keenum again here on second and 10. And this one hauled in by Rudolph. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. From the gun on third down, Keenum eluding the pressure right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. They do go for it. It's Keenum. That's caught by Treadwell. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. Keenum gonna throw. Escaping the pressure right, and nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Sometimes the coverage is so good, no matter what you're doing on offense, you just can't shake anyone free. They try their best to find someone open, but they took away every passing alley, every angle, and shut the play down.
And the play goes for 19 yards, gives them a new set of downs. They go play action here on first down. Flushed out right. Wide open receiver complete. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Forbath out to kick this one away. To return it, Alvin Kamara. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 21-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. The intended receiver was Laquon Treadwell. And now it's second down.
Detroit! Here we go now. 3-19!
Off the play fake. Keenum being chased out left. Oh, nice move. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
They'll try to run it in with Murray. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Latavius Murray taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead.
The touchdown was scored by the runner. But the offensive line, they feel like it's theirs. They blocked that one up perfectly, allowed him easy access to the end zone.
Forbath out to kick this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he loses the football a second time. And the Vikings pick up the football. And they're going to bring this one back. It's a fumble return, a scoop and score for the Vikings. So they get the one score kickoff, get a fumble, take it right back to the house. Two quick touchdowns within a matter of about 10 seconds on the game clock.
It's like a big 1-2 punch that may lead to a knockout.
And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This is taken at the 3. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, pump the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
A reminder, as we did all through the regular season, we'll check in with Larry Ridley at halftime. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half of play. Breeze to throw on second down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. Ingram churning. He lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And now 3 drives. 3 fumbles.
What's amazing about it is when we go around and watch practices, how many times do we see them put that sleeve over a football now to make it more slippery and hard to handle? It's almost like they're playing with that sleeve up.
And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Kyle Rudolph from 8 yards out. And this Viking offense is running away with this one.
A good tight end is a heck of a weapon for any quarterback, especially when you're able to create some mismatches. Sometimes they work against a linebacker, sometimes they work against a smaller defensive back. But when they find it, they go to it, and it often results in touchdowns.
Forbath out to kick this one away. This fielded at the 2. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital.
Now Breeze lost the football. And the Vikings pick up the football. And they're going to bring this one back. It's a fumble return, a scoop and score for the Vikings. This first half has been a nightmare for that offense. Defense just dominating them.
And when you're picking up the ball, picking up their mistakes, and taking it the other way and putting it in the end zone, that's a defense's dream. They're having that type of a game.
Everything that can go wrong has gone wrong for this offensive unit.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Now we'll see what Michael Thomas and the rest of the offense has in store here. Hasn't had his best day to this point here in the second quarter. They're losing. You got to think, though, that also means that maybe the defense doing a good job on it. There's two sides to that coin.
I would agree, so you have to give them credit, but that means you've got to find a way to beat that defense and make sure one of your top playmakers touches the football and has an impact on the game. Change formations, change where he lines up, put him in motion. Anything possible to shake him free.
Maybe that greater impact comes here on this drive. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. Throwing on first down is Breeze. And this is going to be caught, but they'll say out of bounds. So it's incomplete. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course. Well, they'll get the yardage, but they hate to see him take that hit.
You're always trying to cool off a big-time guy throwing the ball, but you have to know when to back off, pull up, and not hit him. There's the penalty.
On first down, Breeze. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. Touchdown, New Orleans. A great play there. 41 yards. And the Saints are able to eat in just a bit to this sizable deficit. Getting your back involved, what's the importance there in the passing game?
Well, oftentimes you can create mismatches because who's going to cover him? And you get him into space, which is where he likes to operate with the ball in his hands. Oftentimes makes people miss, gets that run after the catch, and off he goes.
And into the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. They've really distanced themselves. They have put the pedal to the metal, I guess, so to speak.
So definitely have them in the rearview mirror, don't they? I mean, you're exactly right. Being able to string together these drives that end up in points, it's almost like a run in basketball to create that distance, and they're on a really big-time one right now.
It becomes contagious, doesn't it?
It absolutely does, because oftentimes it translates to your defense as well, because they're excited about getting the ball back for their offense that's playing so well.
Well, they are clicking right now. And he's taken down here by the Saints. The Vikings on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 15. Shotgun snap for Keenum. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. And whistle blown. A timeout here is taken, and it's taken by the kicking team. As the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. And Quigley now on to punt as he sends this one away. Now it's Ginn. 35 yards that time on the punt. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here, first and 10. Drew Brees getting ready to go again on offense. Been a decent start for him here in this first half, but bottom line, his team's losing. They got to fix something.
And it starts with him. He has to keep that little quarterback strut going right now.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Ted Ginn. As the first half is winding down, and the Saints are able to cash in for 6.
Well, that touchdown certainly helps, but they've got to go ahead and convert, get to the half, and figure out how to keep chopping down this lead in the second, don't they?
Yeah, they still need to regroup, and they still need to end the second quarter strong. A little bit of time left. Fielded about a yard deep. The 40, 30, 20. And they are finally going to stop him, but what a return. All the way to the 10.
Similar to golf, you never want to count a score before it actually happens, but you have to figure, they thought they were going to get six on that play. Great effort to keep them out of the end zone, but a big-time return.
And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. And with just 1 second remaining in the first half, they'll call the timeout. So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And this is no good. Close, but he missed it. Hold that thought, Mr. Ridley. We've got a trip to the title game on the line. Folks are eager to get right back to the action. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded a few yards into the end zone, and he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. That's out to Hill, right side complete. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know.
Touchdown, New Orleans! Josh Hill, 55 yards. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. When they drew that up, I don't think they envisioned it ending in a house call. But he got it and took it all the way home.
Really impressive run after the catch, wasn't it? That was really special by him. But let's face it, in today's NFL, those tight ends are often former wide receivers or maybe even sometimes bigger running backs. They just put them in a position to get a great matchup and make plays like that.
And Hill running right through it. And heavy contact. He is knocked down hard. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. And they have to feel like they missed on an opportunity for points last time when they couldn't connect on that short field goal try.
And no doubt about it, because they were counting on those points. In today's NFL, let's face it, that's really a chip shot, right?
That's anything inside 40.
Yeah, they're counting on that going through the post. But we've seen it happen to teams before. Some of the best kickers in the world can miss kicks like that. Can they come back now and redeem themselves?
Rolling to his right. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. On first down, Murray. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. They go with Murray again. Yards is the pickup there, and they'll be faced with a third and inches.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Keenum on third down. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to record another sack. Their sixth of the afternoon.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. Six sacks given up in this one.
And the punt team on now as this one sent away. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. If they're going to take it in for another touchdown like they did on their last drive, they're going to have to do it the hard way, starting at the one.
And boy, is that a difficult position. Obviously,
in trouble, and the ball's out. It's in the end zone, loose. Fighting to get back to the goal line. I don't think he got there. He did not. Did not get back there. It's a safety. Well, I think you can go ahead and give your punter an assist on that one. Pinned him deep, and the defense comes through with 2 points.
You're exactly right, partner. This was all set up by a great punt, and if the ball goes in the end zone, this never happens. So great call. Give the punt team and the punter some love.
And now out comes Minnesota. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now wants to get a cushion, put people away. They want to run their offense and have it end up in the end zone.
Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Let's go! Green, 39! Green!
Keenum now on first down. Flush to his right. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
Here's Keenum now on second down. Fighting down past the 45. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Now a first down throw. Keenum. The throw left side complete to Treadwell. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. 10 yards still left on second down. A shotgun snap for Keenum. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. That catch good for 5. It's third down. The Vikings on third down. A pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. This will be third and 6. Keenum throwing once more. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Cameron Jordan able to disrupt yet another pass play. His third sack of the afternoon. Keenum to throw for it on fourth. Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he's going to go out of bounds. He takes this one down shy of the 20. It's a pickup of 21. And it'll be a Minnesota first down.
And that's a big pickup of a first down. And you know that all week, both sides of the ball, offense and defense, are going through every situation. And in this case, the offensive guys had the right play dialed up, because defensively, you work on fourth down situations as well.
And deflating for the defense. And we return, welcoming you back to Minneapolis. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point, as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. To throw is Keenum, eluding the pressure right. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, first down.
Trip, trip. All right, here we go. Green.
Now a play fake here on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. And quickly, they get to the line. Second down, here's Keenum. And the pressure gets to him again. Bantiteo in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays. Third and long, it's Keenum. Under pressure again, and down he goes again. Cameron Jordan, who else? He's in there for his 4th sack of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
So it's 3 more points, and that widens things out even further here in the 4th.
Hey, in this league, you can never have too much. So if you're in range, grab the 3 whenever you can.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Now a loose football. Coleman lost it. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. A handoff. It's Murray. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
Oh, he almost had it for the pick. A great chance there for the interception in the end zone. Instead, third down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charlie, are you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure.
And he's taken down here by the Saints. Here's Ryan Quigley now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the four and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
On target over the middle to Hill. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
On second down, here's Breeze. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. Breeze finding Snead there for a Saint first down.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was trying to get it that time to Ted Ginn. And it's second down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down.
I know for us it's fun, and it's not so much fun for the rookie receivers when we see them coming into the league and we're at training camps. You see them working on getting 2 feet down instead of one. But the best ones train in college trying to get two down instead of one, so the transition's a little bit less. In this case, though, wasn't able to complete it anyway.
Breeze on the hook up to Thomas for the New Orleans first. Time for a break. This one all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. Thomas has got it. Complete. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Michael Thomas, 52 yards. And the Saints get a bit closer. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, That meant fly route, go. Uh-oh, look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And it's a fumble. Room here to run. Fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what...
A breakaway from Michael Thomas, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Michael Thomas with now 2 fourth quarter touchdowns, and the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit.
And that touchdown puts us in a position to have a discussion, doesn't it? Now, it'll be a 2-score game after the conversion.
Yeah, I mean, there's no doubt with a 2-score game, they're going to have to onside kick it. We'll just see if they've got a miracle up their sleeve.
And you wonder what onside kicks they're going to use and in what sequence if they hope to have a chance to win this game.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this.
Let's go.
Now it's the backup, Bridgewater. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's third down. They got the win last week despite not having any interceptions. Tried to come up with one there, could not. But there's a stat category called PBU, pass breakup. That's important too, and they got one.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it because...
And they're going to get him. He's taken down for a sack back at the 47-yard line.
And the Saints signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Here's Ginn. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Now we'll see what Michael Thomas and the rest of the offense has in store here. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it? Right. Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Now Breeze. His throw incomplete. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
They really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Now Breeze. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. And give him a gain of 37. On first and 10, here's Breeze. Now Breeze lost the football. Breeze, one of the best ever in these situations as he's trying to get his guy set. And with just over 40 seconds now remaining, he gets up and spikes it. The Saints on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 19. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete.
Got to be wary of throwing an interception here because the defense knows they're going to get tested deep. That's why they're going to put a couple of extra guys back there to try and prevent that.
Yeah, late in the fourth quarter here, trying to preserve the lead. Now Breeze, got to have this one. Now a desperate, this is caught.
caught inside the 15. It's a pickup of 33 yards. And that leads to a New Orleans first down. And there's the spike. It stops the clock at 22 seconds remaining. Offense still needing 10 yards. Second down. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. He dumps it down to Ingram. And he takes it inside the 10 to the 8 before he's out of bounds. It'll be a gain of 4. And they're going to have a third down.
Was that a receiver? Yeah, actually it was. It was a running back who was a receiver on the play. Ike's been spending time in the receiver drills getting his feet down.
Yeah, those guys out of the backfield, they got to be good, agile. And he is into the end zone for the touchdown. So they still need a miracle with a clock where it's at, but they get one piece to the puzzle done.
Still have hope. I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed. But if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively, though, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right. And if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
It doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Victory formation time for the Vikings as they'll take a knee here. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. And they will take a knee here. So they stay alive in the NFL playoffs, move on to the conference championship, and do you think that the printing press is starting to get those T-shirts and hats ready, my friend?
They have to, Brandon. They have to be ready, because if you win, you've got to hand those out on the field right away. And just think about the pressure for the players now. Families are going to be talking about tickets to the Super Bowl even before you play the conference championship game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the Vikings, as we say so.